I'm no different than anybody else. I mean, I'm afraid of change sometimes, you know, and it's like, man, this product's working pretty good for me. I mean, cool, thanks, but you know, yeah, just leave that for your collision repair guys. First learning to paint, they never had waterborne paints. So everything was all solvent-based. Then PPG started developing and they were coming out with the ENVIROBASE system. And I'm no different than anybody else. I mean, I'm afraid of change sometimes, you know, and it's like, man, this product's working pretty good for me. I mean, cool, thanks, but you know, yeah, just leave that for your collision repair guys, right? But then it was one of those things that it's like, you know what, I need to try it. You know, I was hearing good stuff about it. And so, you know, they put it in my hands to be able to test and to play with. And I was an idiot for not switching any sooner than I did. It's hard to explain the brilliance of the color, because I was, to be honest with you, that was the first thing I noticed, is how clean of a color I could make with water as compared to a solvent. Now, I'm not a chemist, I can't explain why that is, but it was just the transparency and the brilliancy of the color and the ease of application. So you gotta understand, when we're painting stuff, we're painting parts completely blown apart. And with solvents, air pressure, temperature, it's very finicky. So you can have, at your end outcome, you can have different shades, different colors, the way those metallics lay down. And so you had to be very careful. If I'm painting a car completely blown apart and underneath pieces, it was very hard to be able to make sure when I bolted that thing all back together that it was gonna match. With water, it always matches. The color matching is unbelievable. And so for us in the show car world, it's like, man, what a game changer. You know, I can paint all of this stuff, and if I do the procedures the way you're taught, and if you follow the manual, you know, and do your control coat, it's, man, it's dead nuts on every time. So for me, I still do that. I will paint a car completely blown apart, but on my final coat of EHP, I do hang the doors, put the fenders up there to do my control coat. But I'm not kidding you, it's like most of the time we go through the headache and the stress of hanging doors, and it's like my guy Dan, always look at him, it's like, why do we do this? Because that's extra work that I don't need to do, because it always matches. But I'm still, you got that still hesitation, but every time we hang a door on a car, painted completely apart, it's dead nuts on.